King of glory, the King above all kings. that you've done for me.
The Bible tells the story of a man that was at a gate when Jesus was walking by, and the crowd tried to silence him, but Scripture says he cried out even louder, the more louder. Has God given you grace? Can we shout out and give him praise and glory in the house for what he's done for you? God inhabits the praises of his people, and I'm going to tell you, when you're worshiping him, you are aligning yourself to receive. The universal sign of surrender is raising your hands. If you're at home watching online, or right where you're at, if you're comfortable, this is our intentional night of worship. It's our intentional night to raise up the name of the deliverer, the guide, and the one that can set us free, the God of all creation. And that is the wonderful counselor, mighty God, the one that gives us grace and freedom in his powerful name. Give him praise in the house tonight. We're going to allow you to be seated. Isn't this awesome? I'm going to tell you something amazing. In our leadership meeting the other night, Pastor was talking about my favorite word, and that is being intentional. That in 2020, when fear was striking our nation and the world, Pastor said, we're going to change the dimension of our focus, and we're going to begin to intentionally worship God in the midst of fear so that fear can bow. No matter what you're facing tonight, let me encourage you to press in. This is not just a night of worship for you to sit back and hear music. It's a night for you to find breakthrough and change, because when you edify and worship Him, walls begin to crumble, walls begin to come down, and change takes place. As a matter of fact, when you worship Him, not only does change take place, but your life begins to change. As a matter of fact, there's a young man that is in our congregation that, because he began to worship God consistently and look to Him for all things in his life, God consistently began to set him free, set his feet on a path, and bring him change and deliverance because he was worshiping the one that had the ability to bring him freedom. Welcome Michael Allen with me tonight.
Thank you, Pastor. Hey, good evening, congregation. How's everybody doing tonight? Man, I'd just like to speak with you for a minute to share a little bit about the Lord, man. The Lord has been so good to me, and not only to me, but to each and every one of you. And I love it when I have the opportunities to come and share with you people some of the things that He has done, because the way that God can work most is when we open up our clothes, when we let people see our scars, when we let people see our wounds, when we let people see the things that we struggle with. That is when He is able to free us from them things. Because in being a loving Father and a loving God, He's not going to come and force you to give Him something. What kind of love would that be if He forced you to love Him? It wouldn't be love if everything was just given to you. I know when I gave my life to the Lord here in July of 2003, little did I know when I asked God to change my life that I would spend 11 and a half years in the penitentiary from the time I gave my life to Him. Not really that time, but on a couple of different stints, I went down there and did some time. But it was in those times that at first I was angry and I didn't understand the process that God was working. But it's almost like olives in the oil. They press them, they roll them, they crush them, they try to get that oil out. But He had to do some purging of the world. Purging of the things that I had been raised up, the things that I had been taught, the things that I had grown to be accustomed to and think was acceptable in my life because of my surroundings. Little did I know that God had different plans for me. I would have never imagined that I'd be standing here one day sober, praising the Lord, because I learned that your battles ain't fought with this, they ain't fought with weapons, but your battles are fought on your knees when you can pray. Your battles are fought when you can give it to God, and then you begin to look back at your life, and your life begins to change so slowly that you don't even realize it, but people begin to notice that there's something different about you. They begin to see that there's a light in you. And I can tell you, in that penitentiary, some people may think that's the worst thing. That's one of the best things ever happened to my life, because it took me away from the world. It took me away from my phone, from my friends, from everybody, and it set me down. And I was a knucklehead, so it took me a few years to begin to realize that, hey, when I read the Word, when I pray, when I go to church and I can lift my hands, things began to change. Things began to move. And it was in those times and in the moments that God was able to use the things that I had been taught through the addictions and the bondages and the slaveries and the things that I had seen in the world to see that it's more than what we can see with our eyes or we can hear with our ears or we can smell or we can taste or we can touch. There's something happening around us at all times, whether we know it or not, whether we truly believe it in our heart or not. But because of the things I've seen when I was lost in my addiction and I stayed up for weeks at a time and I didn't eat and I fasted for the devil, I truly believe in fasting for the Lord. And I know what happens on the other side of the coin, because there's a heads and there's a tails. And in that side, you see walls begin to break. And those prisons that I was locked up in are nothing compared to the prisons that some of us live in right here. Some of the prisons that we live in right here in our heart, the doubt, the abandonment issues, the lack of father figures, mother figures, the brokenness that we feel, the shame, the guilt, the remorse, the loss of hope. But I can tell you today that there's a living hope, and His name is Jesus Christ. He is here to set people free. The thing that I had to learn most about my life is because I kept running to a wall because I kept trying to do things. But when I began to look back, like just kind of like He's talking right now, things in my life are going so good. And it's only as I seek the Lord that I begin to realize that they're going good, and I can see Him moving in my life and opening doors and strategically placing brothers and sisters in Christ in my pathway to open up more doors, to make a way where I thought that there would be none, as He stretches my faith. Because you know what the best part of praise is? I want to be like a palm tree. If you see palm trees, they're standing through every storm. When he said, I'll walk through the valley of shadow of death, he knew he was going through it. We don't need to stop and look at the side or look over here and look. We're going to go through it. And I want to be like that palm tree that's so full of water on its inside that it can bend and it can be praising through the whole storm. And when it comes through that storm and that sun shines again and resonates, his leaves get so green, the palm tree begins producing again, and then it grows even taller. Man, I want you people to know God loves you, man. God cares about every one of you children, about your future, about your plans. And he got plans and wants to do things in your life that you could never imagine if you'll let him. But he's not going to force you. But I can tell you, if you take it one day at a time, because one thing's for sure, we're not guaranteed tomorrow. I'm not even guaranteed this next heartbeat. I could fall out right here. But do I know in my heart and in my mind where I'm going to wake up when I stand before that throne and he says, so what'd you do? It's a little late now to accept me, you know? Do you really believe? Just want you guys to know, great things are in store for all of us, man. Keep coming, keep pressing in, and no matter what, you win your true victories when you can praise them in the valleys. At this time, I'd like everybody to stand up. I'd like to say a prayer for you, Gwen, for your family, for your mom. Our Heavenly Father, come boldly before your throne of grace in Jesus Christ, this holy, magnificent, mighty name. And I just thank you for this day, Lord. I thank you with all of my brothers and sisters that are listening, but people that are here in this congregation. And I know, Father God, right now in Jesus' name, that healing is taking place. I know that peace is surrounding their family in these trying times, and that you're casting doubtful spirits out of their path. Father God, that you're taking the enemy and you're breaking him down and you're crumbling him and you're destroying all the tools that he is coming to try to use against them in this trying times, and you're helping them to press in, to be like that palm tree, to be able to raise their hands, to be able to praise him in this time, Lord, and say, no matter what, I will still serve you, Lord. Whether I live or I die, I fall, or anything that can happen, I will still serve you. And when you come to a place in your life like that, God can work in us and through us. So right now, Lord, touch all of their hearts. Touch everybody that's hearing this message, Lord, and just let them see that you are with us at all times, through the good, the bad, the ups, the downs, the all-arounds. And if we'll let you, you will transform our lives in ways that will come and touch everybody's lives around us. We love you and praise you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Woo. Thank you, Jesus.
Song we could ever sing, worthy of all the praise we could ever bring, worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you, we live for you. There is no one like you.
I want you to stay with me a few moments. What you're seeing tonight, and even with those that are coming down to these altars, literally tonight, God wants to bring you to a place that you can realize whatever you're facing, it's not going to move you. Joshua tells the story of when Moses died. Joshua now had the helm. He was now leading in a new path, in a new direction. You may be facing something tonight that you feel like, Brian, this is foreign to me. I don't know where I'm going to go with this. I don't know what to do. But Joshua 1:9 said, have I not commanded you? Be strong, be courageous, for the Lord your God goes with you wherever you go. You don't have to be afraid. You don't have to be dismayed. He's right there with you in the midst of your situation. And you may be saying, Brian, there's some walls in my life that I can't see past. I can't see past. Past that doctor's report. I can't see past that relational situation. I can't see past that addiction. I can't see past that problem. Well, I want to tell you what happened to Joshua. Is Joshua, when he crossed the River Jordan, God showed him that there was nothing that was going to keep him from the promised land. And if you're facing a wall tonight that looks impenetrable, I'm going to tell you, Joshua told the priest, he said, you go out and we're going to circle Jericho. Yeah. Those walls that look like they will never come down, those impossible situations, he said, I want you to go out and I want you to go around them. I want you to put the priests in front of them with trumpets. I want you to begin to blow those trumpets. And when I make it around that seventh time, I want you to begin to shout, 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 shout. God wants to bring walls down that you can't take down in yourself. God says these altars are open and he's about to bring walls down. As we continue to worship, I'm going to tell you, if you feel that urge to move out of your seat, I'm going to tell you, when you move, God moves and walls are going to come down. Give him praise in the house tonight.
Hallelujah, in the presence of my enemies, I raise a hallelujah, woo! Louder than the unbelief, I raise a love.
Thank you for moving in the things that we can't see tonight. Thank you for moving, even though we can't see it or perceive it, we thank you that you're moving and you're working. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, we love you, Jesus. Oh, we bless your name. We bless your name. Hallelujah. Oh, as we just press in tonight, we want to just spend some time with Jesus. Let's get face to face. Jesus, you're worthy. You're worthy of our praise. You are worthy. Jesus, we love you. Oh, how we love you. You are the one God. Our
I'm going to need some help from our prayer partners, because I believe that there's a not only a sweet spirit, but a healing spirit in this house tonight. And I'm hearing, I want to pray specifically for if there's anyone or someone you know that either the left jaw or the upper neck right under the jaw, there's an issue there. I don't know if it's a clicking in the jaw or if there's a growth, but also a loss of sleep primarily caused by anxiety. I've been dealing with that and I'm ready to get rid of it, so I need to pray for somebody tonight. If you have another need, come down as we worship, because our prayer partners are going to be down here to pray for you. But I want to remind you to bring a heart of expectation, because we're going to pray for you from a place of victory. We're not going to pray for victory. We're going to pray from a place of victory, because we've already got the victory. Prayer partners, remember, Jesus healed everyone that came to him. Every single person that encountered Jesus was healed. And his example is the only one that we need to follow.
Prayer partners, you guys can make your way to the front if you're available. So for this next song, if you have a need tonight, we're in the presence of God, and that's where needs can be met. So we just invite you to come and connect with the prayer partner.
Caught up in your presence, I just wanna sit here at your feet. Caught up in this holy moment, never wanna leave. I'm not here for blessings, Jesus, you don't owe me everything. More than anything that you can do, I just want you. I'm sorry when I come with my agenda. I'm sorry I forgot that you're enough. So take me back to where I started. I open up my heart to you. I'm sorry when I've just gone through the motions. I'm sorry, Lord. I just sing another song. Take me back to where we started. I open up my heart to you. Oh, we're caught up in your presence. Ooh. I just wanna sit here at your feet, caught up in this holy. For blessings, no. Jesus, you don't owe me anything, Lord, more than anything that you can do.
I just want you.
I just want you. Nothing else, nothing else, nothing else will do. I just want you. Nothing. Of heaven, pour your spirit out, pour your spirit out, holy anointing, holy anointing, the power of your presence, pour your spirit out, oh, pour your spirit out. We need you, Lord. We need a fresh wind. Anointing, the power of your presence, pour your spirit out, pour your spirit out. Yeah. Ooh, Jesus. Oh, Holy Spirit, thank you for moving in this place. Hearts that burn, holy feet, purify faith and define our spine, strengthen what remains. So we the church bear your light, lamp of flame, city bright, king and kingdom.
For hearts that burn with holy fear, purify faith in me, refine our strength. Church, bear your light, lamp of flame, city bright, King and kingdom come is what we pray. So we need a fresh wind, the ravens of heaven, pour your spirit out, pour your spirit out,
holy anointing,
holy anointing. Of your presence, pour your spirit out,
oh boy,
pour your spirit out,
oh pour your spirit out,
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 pour your spirit out.
I want to remind somebody in here tonight that God will finish what he has started in your life. You might have a dream that you've given up on, but he hasn't given up on you or the dream that he gave you. He will finish what he has started. In Matthew 10, we find Jesus talking to his disciples. He tells them to heal the sick, raise the dead, cleanse those with leprosy, cast out demons. Freely you've received, freely give. Guess what we're supposed to do? Heal the sick, raise the dead, cleanse the lepers, cast out demons. I love how the Message Bible puts it. It says that Jesus sent his 12 harvest hands, out with this charge. Don't begin by traveling to some far-off place to convert unbelievers. And don't try to be dramatic by tackling some public enemy. Go to the lost, the confused people right here in the neighborhood. Tell them that the kingdom is here. Bring health to the sick. Did you hear that? Bring health to the sick. It doesn't say take them to health. It says bring health to the sick. Raise the dead. Touch the untouchables. Kick out the demons. You have been treated generously, so live generously. Jesus is the perfect example. Every person that came to him was healed. I seriously want to see a dead person get up. Like, to the point that you probably don't want me going to a funeral. In all seriousness, I've already done it. The dead person didn't rise, but I'm ready to see him. I whispered in her ear and she didn't respond. That's not on Jesus, that's on me. Maybe my faith wasn't strong enough, but it's getting there. God will finish what he started. Bill Johnson says it is inconsistent to have Jesus pay a price for healing and for us to believe it is not God's intention to heal. If God doesn't want to heal, he has to look his son in the eyes and say, sorry you got on the cross. It was all for naught. But he can't do that. Jesus holds the keys to death, hell, and the grave. And if that's true, that means cancer's defeated. It means that bankruptcy is defeated. Bad relationships, addiction, freedom from porn. I don't want to know who it is. Just receive it. Freedom from that addiction. And a restoration to your marriage when you talk to your spouse about it. It's pretty scary. Trust me, but there's a freedom there. Trust me. Papa Ulch, can you come down here? This is like one of the godfathers of our church. Not the gangster kind, but the kind you go to when you need something. He's pretty gangster too, though. Will you lay your hands on Gwen? Will you put your hand on Gwen for me? Will you all stretch your hands toward Gwen? I received a text the other day that said, hey, Papa Ulch. I received a text the other day that said, we didn't get a good result from the test. And my instant reply was, I remember a story of an England having a mass behind his eye and God took care of it. Cancer is already defeated. Lord, we thank you for Pastor Brenda. We thank you that you have already carried the pain, the suffering, the discomfort, the frustration, the anxiety, anything to do with cancer and sickness. We speak to those cells and we say, line up with the word of God that says you are healed and whole. On a cellular level, there is no dysfunction. Every cell is healthy. Health is reproducing within her body and killing off the bad cells. We release peace, joy, and love. God, we thank you for strength. We thank you just for your peace, Lord. Holy Spirit, smother her in peace. Drown her in peace. Calm her mind, but put joy in her spirit. Cancer, no more. You've already been beat once. You're being beat a second time, and you're done with this family. We break cancer from the England family. We call it null and void, and we thank you for two testimonies in the England household. We thank you for an increase in the platform to share those testimonies. We call this a house of healing, and it extends into the houses that we can reach. It extends into our neighborhood. Give it up, cancer. Just give it up. In Jesus' name, amen.
Young people, we are so proud of you. Thank you for being here tonight. Thank you for bringing your anointing here. You know, you guys carry a special anointing that you have. Jesus on the inside of you, and you brought your Jesus with you, and I appreciate that. We wouldn't be complete without you guys. Thank you for being here. You guys are called for such a time as this. You guys are called to be light in the darkness in your school, at your jobs, in your families, and I just released tonight that you guys are on fire. I release tonight that the Lord is opening doors of opportunities for you to share what Jesus is doing in your life. And I believe that the Lord is going to baptize you in boldness for such a time as this. And person right behind with the sweater and you got your, hi, get your mask on. How's it going? Hey, I see you too. Jesus sees you. He sees you and he sees every detail and he loves you so much. He cares about every single thing. I want you to be encouraged tonight with a view. Be encouraged. He's got good plans for you. Like what Sean just said, what the Lord has started, he will finish for you. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, we're going to do one more. Can you guys hang on for like 5 more minutes and do one more? Okay. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, we bless your name, Lord. Hallelujah. Tried so hard to see it, took me so long to believe it. You choose someone like me to carry your victory. He chose you guys.
You give what we don't deserve it. You for when you stand undefeated. Every battle you run, I am who you say I am. You crown me with confidence. I am seated in the heavenly place, undefeated with the one who has conquered it all.
David said to the Philistine, you come against me with sword and spear and javelin, but I come against you in the name of the Lord Almighty, the God of the armies of Israel, whom you've defied. This day, the Lord will deliver you. If you're marching around a wall tonight, just like the walls of Jericho, don't you stop on that first trip. Don't you stop on that second trip. You keep taking the steps of faith until you see what God has for you. Don't stop short of what God has for you. You're good. And we thank you that we are vessels of the kingdom who shift atmospheres that we walk into. Lord, we release favor and increase into this household. In Jesus' name, amen. As we close this night, I want to invite you as a corporate body. Ari and I have been doing this since we heard about Pastor Brenda. As a corporate body, join us in taking communion each and every day for Pastor Brenda and for anyone else that you know that is sick. We're going to do this through the end of May. That's about 32, 33 days. And we're expecting something. We're not doing it blindly. We are expecting. We love y'all. Good night.